Hi everyone, what's up? It's Joshua here with Alternative Brewing. And today we're going to be brewing delicious coffee using the copper Çözver pot. Now, Çözver coffee, more commonly referred to as Turkish coffee, or perhaps even Ibrik, is one of the oldest and most traditional ways to brew coffee. And whilst espresso is quite a new thing around the world, Çözver has been around for centuries and is a popular brewing method throughout several different cultures, known by different names but sharing powerful historical significance. Now, if you're looking to brew your own Turkish coffee, you can by following this link up above. There you'll find several different sizes in copper and stainless steel Turkish pots available, but stay with me now as we explore a new way to brew with this old method. So the Turkish copper Çözver is a simple metal vessel with a handle sticking out of it. Depending on how many people you plan to serve, depends on the size of the Çözver you need, though you can brew smaller batches in a large one. The brew ratio of coffee to water recipe commonly used with a Çözver is 1 part of coffee to 10 parts of water. And this method surprisingly brews a very strong cup of coffee with very little amount of coffee used, as we won't be filtering the coffee out at all. And the key here is in the grind size. First up, we're going to weigh out 7 grams of beans per cup of coffee we're making. I'll be making 2 cups, so I'm using 14 grams of beans, and I'm gonna add this to my grinder and grind as fine as it will go. It's a consistency that most closely resembles flour, and most electric burr grinders will be capable of this, and there are a handful of hand grinders too that can achieve this fine grind. Next, add your ground coffee into the Çözver, and then with 60 degrees Celsius water, although you can make it with cold water too, though the brew time will be a little bit slower, add 70 mils of water per cup of coffee. From here, a gentle stir just to get it all mixed in before placing it on the stove on a medium to high heat. And now is the time, if you prefer, to be adding in your sugar. The idea with adding your sugar in now is to avoid stirring afterwards, as this will allow the crystals to caramelize on the bottom of your Çözver pot and then slowly melt into the brew rather than dissolving quickly through a stir. And now all we have to do is wait. This is not a brewing method you should walk away from. As we're keeping an eye on the pot, it shouldn't take any more than a few minutes, as when the temperature begins to rise, so will a foam that's created on top of the coffee, sometimes spilling over the top. So you want to be able to remove the pot off when this happens, and then that will stop that foam from rising. Then immediately pour the foam off nice and slowly into your cups, and you can place it back on the stove here to bring up more foam if you like and keep serving it that way. And if you're making more than 1 cup at a time, it's always best to spread the coffee evenly amongst the cups to regulate similar strengths in each coffee. And there you have it, Turkish coffee, customarily enjoyed alongside a dessert like a Turkish delight and a glass of water. Now, I would leave that coffee to cool down as it can be quite hot straight off the stove. And this process also helps with those grounds that we haven't even filtered out yet to slowly settle to the bottom of the cup before we can then gently sip off the top of the coffee and enjoy all of its richness. And that's how you make Turkish coffee with the Çözver coffee pot. Now, if espresso, as we discover it today, fueled the enlightenment of a third wave artisanal movement into brewing and enjoying great coffee around the world, then the Turkish Çözver coffee pot is undeniably the original brew method that began the world's affair and the love of coffee and caffeine in general. It's a potent brew method with no filter. It's a timeless ritual that has a legacy that lives on. So if you have any questions on the Çözver coffee pot, then throw them in the comment section down below and we'll get straight back to you. Don't forget to hit that little bell icon on your screen, and then that way you stay notified when we bring out new videos just like this every week. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.